Yeah, so the next story about, as the title indicates, it's a crazy story. It's a wild turkey. Well, as this goes, buckle up, it's a long story. I posted in here as about my wife's emotional affair for nearly 2 years ago. I deleted the post, unfortunately, and left the group, since it was necessary for me to pass it all. No, it's not. That's the problem, but with guys that says that kind of thing. You don't have to take that shit up. If emotional affairs, it ends in the majority of the times in physical. The emotional is just a, I would say, the final step. But we'll see about that, how it goes. Oh yeah, found the proof of nearly that I needed nearly 2 years ago. Yeah. That's how he dealt with it, apparently. yes, supposedly it was photographed. Yes, I read that. I never had proof, or only the knowledge that texts were deleted and that my consoled in someone else. Well, it sounds weird off. She admitted to getting too close, but nothing ever happened. And you believe her? That's the sad part of it. I worked on myself and devoted more time to our relationship, since it was a real wake-up call for me that was neglecting, I would say, my wife's unintentionally. The problem is that your neglect is coming from what? That she wants a bigger and better house or better car or something, and you're working your tail off, as they call it. That's neglecting her. It's for her, you know, her choosing to do that, to say that, oh, okay, I'll seek a better job or something like that to maintain a better life, so that you can have the job you have, or not working so much hours. I've been then in the same situation myself. So yeah, when one part is of the wife is having less than one full days of work, then you'll have to take up the slack, and then she says that you are neglecting her. You can't have it both ways. I don't know all the stuff about it. I worked on myself and devoted more time to our relationship, since it was a great wake-up call for me that I was neglecting my wife unintentionally. Life was great after, and our sex life is been really good, especially this year. I started going back to the gym, lifting heavy, and lost about 25 pounds of fat. That's cute, nice, really nice. You're doing all the way. Fat of the course of 8 to 10 months. Yeah, it doesn't. Yeah, it doesn't work that way. It just takes that kind of time. And I'm back to the shape I was in when I was in the army. Thank you for your service, man. Been there myself, so yeah. I feel really good about myself and our relationship. Fast forward to yesterday. Oh, my wife worked nights, and when she got home, I was up and ready to go to work to work out. She took her contracts out and couldn't find her glasses before heading to bed. A couple of hours later, she passed out and I was about to leave for work. So I thought I'd look for her glasses. So she have them when she woke up to pick up for the kids. I couldn't find them in the house, so I went out to her squad car. Okay, she's a police. Okay. Since I thought maybe she left them in there, they weren't. But then when I looked through her bags, I found a vibrator, a thong, and pin war balls. I don't know what that is, but about to find out, aren't we? So picturing this, that a police woman is having all these fun things in her squad car, taking pictures. I would taking pictures of it. Obviously, this made me concerned, considering those aren't something I'd ever expected her to bring to work. We've already been through a lot before, as I mentioned, so I woke her up and asked about it, since we agreed to bring up any issues we had with each other rather than expecting the worst. He said about in the last paragraph that she'll have them when she woke up to pick up the kids. Think about this, they have children together. So I would say ready to get the cesspool. She explained that she used the vibrator. It's marketed as a massage wand. To massage her back under her bulletproof vest and to massage her ACL scar. I have no clue about that. With the balls, she explained that she had been using them to tighten her kegel muscle to make her it tighter for me, since she was self-conscious about it giving birth the second time. The thing was supposedly just an extra pair in case she needed to clean up. Ooh. Oh boy. Here in Denmark, we say that she is swimming on her back and I can't remember what it's called, back crawl or something. We call it work swimming. And she was back crawling that. That's, I would say, baloney all the way. Up to the heavens. Let's see about what this is. She was calm about it and did seem flustered, so I took it for her word. Yeah. Oh yeah. It all seems reasonable enough. Yeah. Well, but it did raise a doubt. A old doubt I had in my back. Yeah. So this morning, while she was asleep, I noticed her left. I noticed her left her Apple Watch in the living room, so I decided to check out the message just in case. I noticed that she had been talking to a girl I'd never heard her mentioned, so I decided to scroll through, since she never really had many female friends, or friends in general, really. You cannot have male friends if you're female. that does not want to, how should we say it, want to F you, period. Or there'll be what is called male orbiters. So that is a pretty darn nasty thing that she's having on. They were talking about the girl's issues she was having having with her husband, and now he is flirting with other girls. My wife was giving her tips on how to flirt with him and to sext with him while he was at work, like she did with me. All fine until my wife said something about enjoying her light and dark side. Oh yeah, cops are dirty, aren't they? Or whatever we can call them that. She told her about how she used a vibrator on this guy's balls while she kept Kepna, not his real name, while she took a dive deeper into him, and how she heard him whisper, I love you. She proceeded to tell her friend that she was going to pull the plug out if he was going to keep that up. She also talked about how she enjoyed being a pet. Silubu, good dog. it's really sad. It is. I'm sitting at this point and can't continue reading. I wake her up and tell her that I'm done with her. I show her the watch and that I can't believe the crap I just read. She's confused because, as it turns out, she deleted everything from her phone. Oh yeah, apparently it did sync with her watch, so everything, it was still on the watch. Lucky me. Ah. There's a lot of diet to digest and a lot of context that is missing, because it would basically it would be a book if I took the time to include it all. Imagine that you could put it on paper and make a book out of it, and just tell it as it is. Yeah, coffee. We need that. Basically, I caught her with undeniable proof that she has no choice but to tell me the truth, since I said I was leaving, no matter what, and that she, at least she owned me the real truth. You need proof, and that is pictures of it. The second second incident that I discovered was with a new guy that supposedly started about 3 weeks after I got pissed when she mentioned the first guy's name and how I didn't care to hear about him ever again. This led to a discussion where I told her that I didn't care about her feelings of neediness as much as I used to, just after she subjected me to an emotional affair. Evidently, this pushed her to seek out someone else's to satisfy other those needs. That's definitely wrong, because I suspect you being a married guy, so you went up the church floor and it says I do. And what are the vows that you signed the papers on? That's the problem with her, that If you are unhappy in your relationship for whatever reason, just end it. Get over it. Don't waste people's time. Time is a valuable commodity that cannot be turned backwards. Time is in now and present. So don't waste people's time. That's say the problem with it I have. So so I guess I should mention that she has been into BDSM and that she wanted to be submissive. I can relate to that when she spoke about being a pet. In simple terms, she wanted to be owned and claimed. That was something. This has been something I've suggested. This is something I've been struggling with because it goes against how I was raised. Yes, and considering she is the woman that took my virginity. Okay. I haven't had many relationships experience outside this one. This is not about physical control with her thought. She enjoys the mental aspect of giving up control. For those unfamiliar with this territory, you should understand that the majority of women draws to this sort of behavior having a serious sexual trauma. Okay. My wife was molested as a young age by her stepbrother. Oh boy. I can feel the hair be in my back. One in my family has been subjugated to that kind of molestation, so I wanted to do something about it, that guy. And if I hear a peep out of that place again that he comes from, he's gonna do something else than finding his ball somewhere else. Because it is incredible how those get away with that kind of stuff, other than hard evidence. Let's see, it was around 8 by a stepbrother, and she has had a couple of experiences with attempted rabies. Yes, you can imagine doing the little fiddling with your wording, rabies. Among other serious, some other serious family issues growing up. Oh, okay. I'm not excusing her action, but she has dealt with more than anyone should. As I think it has developed into a sex addiction. Oh, you think? Oh, well. That's the problem with it. She need, I would say, counseling or something, because, she's a cop and things can be pretty tense if she's out of patrol and something else is going on, and then she snaps or something. Then you have, I would say, dead bodies. So that's thought process that she needs some seriously talking to some shrink or something. I know it's hard to believe, and I almost can't believe it myself, but I think I want to try working through it. I don't know if it is possible, but I can't bring myself to kick her to the curb, even though I know I have a right to. why stay with her? Damn it. I won't say infuriating that someone that basically having it's not open relationship, but it is. It's having a part of you that is on your in your back. It's mind blowing. Just hit the root. Blah blah. What did it say? I know it's hard for me to be. It has to believe. I can't believe myself. Yeah, I don't know. I'll say that. I always thought that this would be the easiest decision. No, it is hard like hell. It is. Especially when you have kids involved. Yeah, I won't say it takes 2 to 4 years for that kind of crap to take up, but that one, she's going to. That's no. It's bonkers. I love her, and I would even consider staying if I did. Yes, get out of the place or kick her out. Oh, I thought that it would be easier decision to make. Leaving on after infidelity. Yes, for some reason I feel I should give it one shot. She's going to no shot at all. Never. She's going to go to counseling to address her abusive past, and we are both going to attend marriage counseling. Yeah, and the marriage counselor is always on the woman's side. So yeah, wasted money. If someone is familiar with the struggle that she's been facing, or maybe dealt with it with similar issues, I would greatly appreciate your input. Any advice or support is welcome. Yeah, this may not work out for us, but I think it's worth a shot. We are both realistic. Are you? That's the yeah. That's the no. That's no way of that's not any way or form telling in this. So here we go. Like and subscribe if you prefer. Nice. Have a toe.